Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 11.2 Beta 3 to developers and soon to public beta testers. This came in at 173.1 megabytes and doesn't bring a whole lot of changes. Let's take a look at the build number. You can see the build is 15C5107A, and this build does not bring a whole lot of changes. In fact, there's not really much you're going to see at all. If you bring open your different apps and you want to switch between them, they've improved some performance between switching apps in the app switcher. That's not really an issue I had much. If you go like this, you can open your apps. There's a little gesture you can do or bring up and hold, but right now it doesn't seem to be working. But with your apps and switching between them, it was a little bit quicker. Now, if you're on Wi-Fi in the control center and you turn it off, it's going to give you a message saying disconnecting nearby Wi-Fi until tomorrow. It lets you know exactly what's going on instead of letting you know it's completely off. Now, it does the same with Bluetooth as well. So if you do Bluetooth, it will give you the exact same message the first time you do it to let you know what's really going on as far as that goes. Other than that, that's really all we see in here. If you do go into notes, you type an I, you don't get that autocorrect anymore, so maybe that's fixed here as well. And that's really just about it. Now, I did go into Geekbench and run a Geekbench, and as you can see here, we've got 4,162 and 10,071. We'll go back to the previous build, and it's a little bit better, but I don't see any slowdowns here. I don't think you're going to have any issues with battery life or anything like that, and I certainly haven't had any issues like that whatsoever on the previous build. I did have some stability issues when downgrading to the previous public version, so I wouldn't suggest doing that. But basically with the beta builds, I think you'll be okay as far as that goes, using them with the betas and using your iPhone 10. Now, on the previous versions of iPhone, like iPhone 8, 8 Plus, you may have some issues here and there. I have seen some issues with iPhone 7s and 7 Pluses that you've let me know about on Twitter, and I appreciate that feedback. Keep that coming. But there isn't a whole lot more to go into as far as this particular update. No iMessage in the cloud and nothing else like that. Performance seems to be solid. Swiping, everything like that, as fast as you would expect on these newer devices. But I'd love to hear your experience in the comments below. Also, if you'd like to send these wallpapers, thanks for sending them. I'll leave a shout out to whoever sent them in the comments, or in the description rather. And thanks again for sending them. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.